is showing you working out. Because you must write your working out to get the full marks.
No, I'm not gone.
I'm playing Donkey Kong.
Well, so has everybody else got their results back apart from me?
1 minute remaining until it's uploaded.
I'm not sure why.
I passed mine.
No, maths exam.
Oh, maths exam, I don't know.
Where did you do it today?
So where am I going to put the five?
No, nothing. We actually did nothing.
Okay.
Okay, where am I going to put five?
Five?
Mm-hmm.
I
don't think
you're
going
to get the
£5 you put that at the beginning. Where?
Where the first one is.
Here?
Yeah.
You're going to write it here?
What do you mean?
To show me working out where, what I'm
going to
write.
Oh, we can do the... You get five.
We know it's 1 to 116.
One title.
So you've got to do 5 times.
So you times by five. Yeah. So you want to times that by five. Which comes to Kadir? 7. And remember, it's money. So always put your 2 decimal places on. At level 2, you will lose a mark if you don't use money format.
Yeah.
So make sure you use money format. Okay, and if you write it like that, that's all the working out you need to show. Because that shows the examiner you know exactly what you're doing. Okay? So have a go at the next one.
That's the battery.
Why are you keeping the finish for?
Okay, have a go at that one.
Yeah, SD card.
How many euros do you get for?
Because it is an 8 GB one.
7.
And I'll fill that up with really good. That. Oh, that shit from thingy. Work. Rust. Whatever.
Look
at Damon. Can I see him? Yeah, me over your long time has been up there.
So I want to see the actual working out.
Yes.
So that you're not losing your arms.
I love your long time. Let me
cut
your
phone.
Hey, shut up!
Port Park.
Oh, Jenny, I feel...
I want to go
high.
Eh?
Feel high.
Eh?
Feel high.
I'm high.
Yeah.
SD card on you. For good news, what's on it? Micro SD card. Insert the micro.
Oh, what's wrong?
Micro SD card inserted.
So can you do currency conversions? You were at
currency
conversions. With this? Mm-hmm. Write it down, so you've got it through
revision,
you can technically
go
on.
This is 99.
Hmm?
Oh.
Oh, yeah, my background. Ni hao.
Oh, ni hao. What's that right? What's that right, Jenny?
Currency conversion. You two all right with it?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you write it out like a table.
Mm-hmm.
So 1 to 116. That needs to be 2 dots. That's it. So that only needs to be one dot.
Should we do the ratio just
to get it? Yeah.
So that's your pounds, and we want £5, so write £5 underneath it. And you think, I've done 1 times 5 to get to 5. So that's times 5. Times that by 5.
I got that thing.
To keep it all in proportion. So whatever you've done from 1 to there, you do exactly the same to find your equivalent.
And they've gone to 7.
Hmm?
7.
Oh, sorry, 7, yeah. The first one was 5. Yeah, put 7 there and change that to times 7.
So you've got to times that by 7.
Yes.
I think they put some.
We've actually all done it wrong.
What?
I didn't read it properly. Read it again.
How many euros do you get for?
Oh no, we've done it right. Ignore it. I'm really not doing well. So you
how
should
do you
have
do
got.
It? Yeah, that's correct.
How about one?
I'm correct. How do you do it?
I'm fat.
How do you do it?
Well, you're
going to
do.
I've got 8 again.
What?
8.12.
Right,
8.
We want
£7, and we know this is the pounds column.
No.
We've
times
that by 7.
So we have
to
times
that.
That's what
I've done. I'm going with it.
Times by 7.
I've got
with it.
That's correct. You'll go. You'll go now.
Yeah, how do you work that out, bro?
Yeah, man.
Okay, so to get from 1 to 32, you times it by 32. So you times that by 32.
Boom, baby!
Got a carpenter, didn't you?
Go on for 7 minutes.
I'm gonna wait until 10 minutes.
End of class.
Remember, you can go column to column as well as row to row. So it could be.
It looks weird.
Or it could be.
Damien, tip our grass up.
Whatever you do.
Yeah. Oh, mine's got a flash.
Oh, you got your light on. That's why he was making all that weird noise.
Gentlemen?
Yeah, man.
Pay attention. So, whichever way you do it, whether you do it the way that Kadir does it, doing it across the columns, or maybe doing it down the rows, whichever way, you're always going to come out with 32 times 1.16.
What do you write? 1 minute, you're telling me where the sign is, I understand it. 1.16, yeah?
Times 32. If 1 is 1.16, 32 is going to be
32. Why are you using 1.16? Why can't you use that other one?
Fuck it up with your hair.
What other one? That's the exchange rate. That's telling you that if you change your money, for every pound, you'll get €0.16.
Oh. Damn, hello!
Yeah, bro,
you
don't know how to do that.
He was it.
Oh la la!
Turn your flash off.
Wow, I like it.
Okay, so a little harder now. You often get 3 decimal places when you're doing currency conversion.
What?
If you round that to be 1.16, but then you change maybe £1,000, you're going to be quite a few euros out. So they try and do it as accurate as possible and round it at the end. So
yeah.
Never round it before you've worked it out, always round it at the end. So, how many euros do you get for £10,000?
£10,000?
Can anyone do it without the calculator?
So no, can't.
Euros.
11,630 euros. And if you rounded it there, you would be 30 euros out, wouldn't you? You wouldn't be getting those 30
boom,
euros, right. Which is quite a lot of money, really. So you only ever round it right at the end.
Did you not do it?
What?
So now we're going to be in 20,000 and 30,000.
What?
How would you do that?
Nothing. 23,260 for 8.
Tell me what you did.
I took the rate times 20,000.
So you did 1.163 times 20,000 on your calculator.
Easy, mate.
Okay? If you didn't have a calculator, what you could do is times it by 10,000 and then just double it.
Yeah?
So, yeah, so we get, what was it? 23,260, is that what you got?
Yeah.
So have a go at the 30,000.
34,890.
And I was going to say, can I have an answer from someone other than Shway? Because I know you know how to do it. But that's fine.
What's your
okay. Okay, now this is back to front now. And this is what I thought that other one was when I thought we'd done it wrong. So we've still got 1.163. And if you put your pounds to euros up there, that will remind you what you want to put in. Oh, it's still not. It's
4 pounds.
Jenny.
So now you've got
4 pounds 6 pence, Jenny.
Okay.
Look at you see.
Times that by 3.5. So you've got to times that by 3.5. Or you've times it by 1.163.
It's like
the
lights over here.
Do you
want
to
ask
Justin?
He's got to let people walk in his college.
Okay. So have a go at this one, but read the question properly.
Chris Brown.
How many pounds do you get for €11.63?
Is it cheap, Giddy? How much do you pay? €300.
Giggity.
What? So it would be if it said how many euros, but it's the other way around.
How did you do it then?
It's £10.
Okay, how did you do it?
The fuck?
So, two ways of looking at
we've
this.
Got 12 minutes.
Make sure you put it under the right column. So, if you put it under there,
minutes.
You'll get the right answer,
13.
Which is what Dylan did. So, we need to put it under the right column, and you're either doing what have I done to get from euros to pounds? I've divided by 1.163. Or what have I done to get from that one to that one? And if you look, it's the same numbers, but the decimal points in a different place. So, what have you done to get from one? To 11. You've times it by what? I know someone's got the right answer.
11.63.
You've times it by 10.
What?
Babies.
Yeah, you've moved your decimal.
What's wrong with my head?
Or you've divided it by 1.163.
Babies.
And your answer should be 10. Burgers. And if you look at it as a four-way table, you can see that everything agrees, it's all to do with timesing by 10 or by 1.163.
That was close to my bowler.
Okay.
Yes, Jenny.
Last two, have a go at those two, please. I want everyone to have a go.
I don't even get it. Okay.
So we're looking for pounds. So put you in.
We're just divided, aren't we? Is
it 3 pence or 2 pence? Start off putting pounds to euros. And you hit exchange rate.
And then you divide it from that.
And then we've got 116.3 euros.
It'll be divided by one.
So put it under here. 116.3 euros.
Divided by the amount.
We've got 116. Yes. So to get from here to here, anything divided by something that equals one is always divided by itself.
What?
Yeah. Oh, I don't like it.
Get it written down in your book. Yes.
Ow! Ow!
I've got one.
Sniff that cock!
What is wrong with you?
Which one of us?
I'm not even doing that. It's just these two here. These great weirdos.
The 19, you're like,
I have any number.
I'm just recording this tree.
Recording a tree for?
Both recording a tree.
And cars.
Okay, so in your books, I want to see the method written down problem, so that you can always use
Illuminatical
this table method for ratio.
Sniff that cock.
So it seems that the only people that are working are those that understand it.
Don't understand it.
Well, write it down in your book. The way I've written it, and then see if you can work it out. So it's asking for you've got euros and you're changing them into pounds. So you need to put the amount you've got under the euros coloured. And then what have you done to get from euros to pounds? We've divided by 1.163.
Oh, got you.
That way we've times. And then you just do this in your calculator. Or, if you can spot that the numbers are the same, just the decimal point in a different place, you can work out how many...
Is it 0.01?
No.
Mate.
So, are you doing 116.3?
Yeah.
Divided by 1.163?
No.
Wait,
So this is your conversion factor.
What, so you do 1.163 divided by 1.163?
You do this amount that you've got and divide it by that amount.
Oh, yeah. 116.3 divided by 1.163.
Yes.
It's a thousand, no minute.
Good.
What? You got it? Come on. I caught it on my pen. You got it, you
want
to.
So, David, what's the first one?
Yeah, was it wet?
First one.
Thousand.
So, what are you doing? 100.
Yeah, 100 foot.
It's moved two places. Well, if you do that divided by that, you will get 100.
Well, if you'd actually listen...
I did listen!
116.3 divided by 1.163.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
116.3. Oh, they're
wrong. They did the second one, didn't they?
Yeah. And so this one is...
1,000.
Excellent.
I got okay, your mind!
That up! So you got it as reference, but you've got it in your book.
Hang on.
So what's the next one be like? 10,000.
Yeah.
And then 100,000 and then a million.
If you added another zero.
Yeah. Give me a
moment. Would you like to make a professional YouTube setup?
Go on.
11 minutes.
Rajiv, do you know what
you're
doing?
Dollars on
18. Oh, sand. Look at that lad.
You can have that one. You can have that one.
Why has it got the bins on?
I don't know. To stop the teachers escaping.
I could, you should have put it in front of the gate.
Oh, both.
Try and do it using...
Oh, there's a shifty shift. Oh, there is actually a silly. And it's type R.
Is it what?
Type R silly.
Where?
Don't know.
Ooh,
I'm a silly.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Black one.
I'm a silly.
Oh,
silly.
Oh,
friends. Oh, friends.
Where's it? Pounds to dollars.
What type of dollars?
It just says dollars.
What?
Where?
US dollars, New Zealand dollars, Australian dollars, Canada dollars.
But then, It says dollars.
Do you mean the first one?
Yeah.
That's euro, is the first one. The second one is US.
US dollars.
Oh, well.
The second one is New Zealand dollars.
I think it doesn't mean the second one. Because it sounds pounds to dollars and it said pounds to dollars.
Fourth one down is Australian dollars. Fifth one's Canadian dollars. South African. I didn't even see all this.
Randy.
Australian dollars.
I didn't see all this here.
Who's Randy?
I fucking told you.
Randy, man.
Fucking first one, pound dollar, you knob.
Ooh, Swiss. Do they have Swiss cheese?
How many dollars do you get in £6? I don't fucking know.
10.
Your mum.
100. 180.
That's what she
said. My balls are big. I bet you I'll get shut down.
That was the van leaving.
Nope, van. Bye, van.
Been still there 5 hours later.